Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle and these two sides are equal, and then these two sides are given 8 and x is asked. Okay, first step, let's draw a perpendicular line, and let's call here K, and this side I'm going to call here A, and this side I want to represent with h. Notice that for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, h squared plus a squared equals h squared, right? Okay. And then if you focus on AKD triangle, let's apply Pythagorean theorem, h squared plus a plus 8 whole squared equals 12 squared, right? And then 8 squared plus a squared plus 16a plus 64 equals 144. Notice that 8 squared plus a squared equals 64, right? Plus 16a plus 64 equals 144, and then 16a equals 144 minus 128, therefore 16a equals 16, so a equals 1 unit. Okay, let's write here a equal 1, and then if a equal 1, that means the length of the BK must be equal x minus 1, right? Okay. And then notice that h squared plus a squared equals 64. We have found a as 1 unit, that means h equal root 63, right? Okay. Let's write here root 63 for this triangle. If we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of x, right? So x minus 1 whole squared plus root 63 whole squared equals 12 squared. That means x minus 1 whole squared equals 144 minus 63. So x minus 1 whole squared equals 81. Let's square root both sides of the equation. That means x minus 1 equals 9. So x is going to be 10 units. Okay. This was the first method. Now we will calculate value of x using second method. Let's call here alpha. This angle must be alpha, right? Because of isosceles string. And then these two sides are equal, that means if here is alpha, this angle is also alpha. And this third angle I want to represent with double line, that means here is also double line, right? So ACD triangle and BAD triangle are similar, right? According to angle similarity theorem. Therefore, 12, which is opposite of the double line, over x plus 8, which is opposite of the double line, must be equal 8, which is opposite of the alpha, over 12, which is opposite of the alpha. Let's simplify the expression. So x plus 8 equals 18. That means x equals 10 units. Okay. This was the second method. Now we will calculate value of alpha using third method. Let's call here alpha again. Notice that if we draw a perpendicular line, we know that the base will be divided into two equal parts, right? Because of isosceles triangle. So if we calculate cosine alpha for this triangle, cosine alpha equal 6 over 8, right? So let's simplify 3 over 4. And then if you focus on ABD triangle, if we apply cosine rule, 12 squared equals x plus 8 whole squared plus 12 squared minus 2 times x plus 8 times 12 times cosine alpha, right? These are again, so 2 times 12 times x plus 8 times cosine alpha, we know that cosine alpha equal 3 over 4 equal x plus 8 whole square, right? And then if you simplify the expression, therefore 18 times x plus 8 equals x plus 8 whole squared, right? So these are again, therefore x plus 8 equals 18, so x equals 10 units. Okay. Now we will calculate value of x using third method. Let's extend corner C as 4 units, and then let's call here K. Notice that these 3 sides are equal, right? That means A is a center point. Right? Because these 3 sides are equal. So if you draw a circle which radius equals 12 units, that means here must be equal 12 units, right? Because of radius. And then notice that if we apply PowerPoint formula for corner C, we get the value of x, right? So this part 20 times this part 4 equal x times 8, right? Okay. And then if you simplify the expression, therefore x equal 10 units. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.